If you're using Final Cut Pro 10 to edit your videos, I have a tip for you how to save quite a bit of space, especially if you're doing lengthy projects or reusing the same music. Every time you're adding an audio track to your project which is encoded in MP3 format, Final Cut Pro 10 will automatically convert this track into a .mov file, and inside that container is LPCM audio file, which is an uncompressed audio format. Obviously, as any uncompressed format, it will generate way larger than usual files. Plus, since it's doing the conversion from previously compressed MP3 file, the whole procedure is kinda useless, especially for people delivering for the web. And being Final Cut Pro, of course, there are very little settings, and you cannot tell program to simply accept MP3 file without this conversion, even when transcoding is turned off. However, there is a trick that can help you save a lot of space, which can be very handy if you're editing your videos on your MacBooks, which, although have really great and extremely fast SSDs nowadays, usually aren't that big in volume. So disk space is a constant concern. Although Final Cut Pro 10 doesn't like standard lossy compressed MP3 files, it actually has nothing against less standard lossy M4A files. So what I would suggest to do, and what I'm doing personally, is transcoding your MP3 files or even uncompressed WAV or AE files to M4A using something like Free Media Human Audio Converter, and after that add them to Final Cut Pro projects. Let's look at example. Let's take a lengthy track, say Kevin MacLeod's Fluidscape, 30-minute track that is available to download from YouTube. Maybe you would want to use it as a background audio for your podcast or something similar. So MP3 file is around 73 megabytes. When we transcode it to M4A file, it stays pretty much the same. When we add MP3 file to Final Cut Pro though, you can see that it actually transcodes it, and the resulting file is 320 megabytes, which is almost 5 times larger than the initial file. However, if we add to this project the same file but in M4A format, it doesn't actually transcode anything, and so you don't end up with massive duplicated files in your project folders. Plus, if you're making content for YouTube on a constant basis and you're reusing some audio tracks, it probably means that you have a lot of duplicated transcoded massive audio files when you could have just transcoded all your tracks to M4A format once, put them into one folder, and then use them for your different projects without wasting disk space. Hopefully you found this little tip useful. If you did, please subscribe and enable notifications, leave a like, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.